marks on mine are not out of the house. They ain't gonna last too long when all you think about is getting me home. Walking through the front door, seeing your blank dress in
everybody. Coming up, the truly talented MacKenzie Porter, the clear country sound of Dustin Lynch will be here, and after that, Chris Young will return for Last Call. Hey everybody, Natalie Stovall here, and all right, everybody in the house, reach over and shake your neighbor's hand. Go ahead. We're friendly here. Congratulations, because all of you are the smartest people in the world, because you're about to see the best show in the world from the greatest stage in the world. But how do you get the people to admire you when you can't be here? You do what all our friends around the world are doing right now. You stream the show, or you watch Opry on your local Circle TV station's digital channel. Check your program guide to find where your circle is, or go to circleallaccess.com/watch. All right, now, take a look at that handsome man over there. There is no person who loves the Opry more than he does. 5 years ago, this coming August, Vince Gill stood right there and asked Chris to be a member of the Opry. Needless to say, it was a surprise. I love you so much. Now, to some of you, that right there might look like sumo wrestling, but what I see is a man who loves the Opry, apparently has deep pockets, and all those who make country music even better, he's a supporter of, even if he has to wrestle them. Here again is Chris Young.
We've all gotta be up early, boys. We ought to shut her down. Just take it to the house before anybody starts getting crazy. So I started walking across the floor. Before I got to the door, oh wow, somebody just bought it. Shine that Patron, hang on. I just might have to stay. The coat's all long gone. I should be halfway home, but I'm not. Girl, I saw you come in with all of your girlfriends. Just couldn't have been shooting the guard in. I got my boys and me. We're just blowing off steam. Not looking to pick up anybody. I was kind of on by. just came on. Come on, DJ, what you gonna do? Oh, wow, it would be so wrong if we didn't dance one show.
I didn't do anything yet. You just got uncomfortable because it got quiet. Everybody's like, "Woo! You're supposed to do something." How y'all doing tonight out here at the Grand Ole Opry? What's up, everybody? My name is Chris Young. It's my pleasure to be standing up here in this circle, and it is it's always a great honor to be on this stage, be able to play a bunch of country music for you guys, and yeah. I'm from right down the road in Murfreesboro, Tennessee, originally. If anybody knows where that is. It's really funny because I just gave up. I started saying Nashville several years ago because I was like, Murfreesboro, Tennessee. It's like 30 minutes away from Nashville. Blank stares. I was like, okay, I'm from Nashville. No way. So much easier. Y'all give it up for this band. These are my guys. We're getting ready to go out on the road right after this performance, so. And man, I've missed doing this. This is a song that I wrote with a couple friends of mine, and I had no idea it was gonna end up blowing up like it did. This one's just called I Can Take It From There. Here we go.
Too much beer, so baby, tell me, would it be alright if we just take a little rain check and stay right here? Sure, we could find something to do. As a matter of fact, baby, why don't you grab a couple glasses and a bottle of wine? We'll walk down the hall and turn down the lights. Baby, while you're at it, you might as well lay down your
standing up on the stage of the Grand Ole Opry. I'm not gonna make you yell for me. I am gonna make you yell for Conway Frick and Twitty, though. We're gonna do that one more time. I can see all up top, too. I wanna hear everybody in this room loud and proud one time when I say Conway. Here we go.
Conway Twitty, kill the ringer on your telephone. Ain't gonna stop loving you till the candle burns out.
of a man. Now tomorrow's gonna be here way too soon. Let's not waste another minute. Girl, I got plans for me and you. So grab a couple glasses and a bottle of wine. Walk down the hall and darling, turn down those lights. Baby, while you're at it, you might as well let down your hair. And I can take it from there. I can take it from there. I can take it from there.
Tonight's Opry performance is brought to you by Sonic. This is how we Sonic.
Chris Young, everybody. That's exactly what the Opry's supposed to sound like, right? Man, that was so good. I got a tippy, boy.
Thank you, girl.
He actually handed me a $100 bill. How are you prepared for that?
I wasn't. I just happened to have it in my pocket.
That was incredible. Okay, you are so amazing because that picture of you and Vince Gill, most people, when they get their invitation to become members, they start crying, they can't speak, they can't compose themselves. This one turns into a superhero of just pure happiness.
I mean, look, first of all, I love Vince Gill. Y'all give it up for Vince one time. And I've been lucky enough to have a number one song with him. I've been lucky enough to get him to know, just to know him over the years. And great dude. And I was too excited. I was like, I'm going to pick him up over my head. And then I was like, maybe I shouldn't have done that to somebody that's in the Hall of Fame. Like, that's probably not cool. But he was okay with it.
I mean, yeah. it really seemed like that was a beautiful moment. And that's a picture that will go down in the history books for sure.
He didn't do the thing where he like leaned in and whispered, put me down. So I figured I was okay.
What are some of your earliest memories growing up just down the road from the Opry? What do you remember of first hearing about the Opry?
Oh, my God. You know, just growing up with my grandfather, listening to Marty Robbins records at the house, he was one of those guys that he would tell me the stories about Marty going, like, way over time and playing, like, 800 songs more than he was supposed to at the end of the night at the Opry. And I was able to get a chance to go with my mom and my sister a couple times. I took flowers to the stage a couple times for people. And it's just great memories. And obviously the past, present, future of country music all meet up in one place. It's pretty awesome.
Just like with you right here with us tonight. Thank you so much for taking the time to talk to us. Absolutely. I know you got more show to get ready for, so go enjoy yourself. Chris
back.
Young. Y'all, this is the most perfect night here at the Opry. Thank you guys all so much for joining us. I'm Natalie Stovall. I'll be out here while TV is in commercial breaks talking to you guys and radio and live streamers. And right now, I gotta get to TV. Hey friends, welcome back to Opry Live. Natalie Stovall here. Now, y'all see that sparkling fountain of talent over there? See her right there? Her journey to this stage began in her hometown of Medicine Hat, Alberta, the starting place for Terry Clark as well. But where Terry went south to Nashville, this one went 14 hours west to Vancouver. She went there pursuing two dreams, acting and music. And let me just tell you, making a living as a musician is almost more than a mere human can take. And I'm betting that goes about double for acting. Pursuing both, that's just superhuman, or maybe crazy. Her trip to Vancouver was 15 years ago, and as of tonight, her TV and movie credits are longer than Crystal Gayle's hair. She has 3 number one songs in Canada, and in the U.S., a 5-week number one song with a fella you'll see later tonight. So it turns out, she's not crazy. She's a superhuman talent, and we're lucky to have her here tonight. Here is MacKenzie Porter.
What's up, Nashville?
We were
one drag off a cigarette. Now we didn't smoke, but we wanted to be cool. We were small town kids, all vintage, just a couple hallway famous fools. We were way overconfident. We were in love and loving it. We were radio junkies, throwback country suckers for the old school. I'm thinking about those days, these days. I'm thinking about a 98 Chevrolet. Think I need low key. Street bags, and park cars. I'm thinking about breakfast and midnight, those matching tattoos and goodbyes. Do you think about those days, these days, baby, like I do? Cause I'm thinking about you. Do you think about those days, these days?
I'm thinking about you.
Yeah, I'm thinking about you. Does it taste like you kiss me when you sip whiskey? Take you back to 17. Time you smell sunscreen, baby. Do you see me dancing on a Bama beach? Do you smile at the thought of it? Do you ever just reminisce when you see an old photo? Wish it was more than just another TV. I'm thinking about those days, these days. I'm thinking about a 98 Chevrolet. Think I need slow keys in my box. The back streets, back seats in my car.
To the Grand Ole Opry. Okay, a lot of y'all. Well, I need to tell you, this is my second time playing here. The first time was just a couple months ago, and I can barely remember it because the first time you stand in that circle, your heart, my heart, was like racing 8 million miles an hour. My parents were sitting right here, and my grandma, and my dad was crying in the front row. And I was like, after that moment, I couldn't remember anything else. So tonight, I get to soak it in with you guys. So thank y'all for being here for my second time. I put out this song just a couple months ago. This one's called Pick Up. I hope y'all like it.
Shifting that I put in the door. Well, that sunshine state sticker on the gate we got in a spring break town. Damn, it's been a minute since I've been in it. Now I'm thinking about whose hands at the window and the windows down. Whose hands on the window and the windows down?
my goodness. Oh, you don't have to run. Look at her running in those heels. You look and sound amazing. Oh, I love that story about you seeing, looking at your dad, and that's, you told me earlier, that was basically the only thing you remembered
from that night. That is the only moment I remember. It's so funny how your brain, like, almost blacks it out.
It really does. And most people say that about their debut, because there's something so incredible about stepping into that circle.
Yeah, I think it's a moment that, as an artist and a country singer, you kind of, like, look forward to your entire life. And when you get there, it's like you want to soak it in so much, but it goes so fast.
Yeah.
So I'm so glad to be back here a second time, because I get to, like, really, really take it in tonight.
Well, and for you growing up in Canada, what were your impressions? Look at all the Canadians in the house.
We have some Canadians in here. All right.
At least some Canadian fans, for sure. Now, what are your earliest memories of the Grand Ole Opry? Were you aware of the Opry stage?
Of course, of course. I think it would probably be like listening to it on the radio with my grandparents. I grew up on a cattle and bison ranch, so my dad is like a full rancher. That's what he does. So that's all we listened to was the radio, and we would listen to the Grand Ole Opry.
Wow. Well, thank you so much for taking the time. You sound amazing. You always look amazing. We love you here at the Opry.
Thank you, girl.
We want you back over and over again. MacKenzie Porter, y'all, give it up. Oh, my goodness. Well, this is such an incredible night. And again, I'm your host, Natalie Stovall. So I'm hanging out with you guys on these TV breaks, but I have to give a big shout out to WSM 650 AM radio listeners who are tuned in. We've got our live streamers tuned in from around the world. And then all of you in the house, the luckiest folks in the world here with us. Now, I want to mention, make sure and stick around at the end of the night. So it's going to seem like the end of the show. We're going to say goodbye to our radio listeners and goodbye to our live streamers and our television audience. But you guys are going to get a little special bonus from Chris Young. So stay in your seats. We'll remind you again here in a little bit so that you get to see that. And also give us some shout outs. Let us know what's going on Twitter. You can tweet or send us some Instagram comments to the Opry or at Natalie Stovall. We would love to give you some shout outs. But I'm going to go to television again. So if y'all don't mind, give us some applause and help me in. Hey, friends, welcome back to Opry Live. Natalie Stovall here. Now, I've been blessed to stand on this stage an awful lot over the past 2 years. I've introduced a lot of crazy talented people, but every single time I see that quiet, friendly, smiling man, where is he? I don't see him. He's somewhere. That's how quiet he is. When I see this next artist, I think to myself, the Lord works in mysterious ways. You see, when he first came to Nashville, he was on track to go to medical school. He was not a music major. 4 years later, he graduated with a BS in biology. So, the way I figure it, if it wasn't for a little bit of luck and a lot of talent, he might very well have been my doctor. Like I said, the Lord works in mysterious ways. Ladies and gentlemen, the very talented and the very smart, Dustin Lynch.
I'm a mama's boy, I'm a fist fight, kind of county line, kind of cold beer, little hat down, little John Deere. I kind of give a damn, I kind of don't care. You see the girl standing right there, she loves a small town boy like me. She's my ride or die, baby, she's my cool, she's my pleasure, she's my lay back in the front seat. She's my with me to the end, I'm turning up the team, girl. A small town boy like me. Yes, he does. She likes my t-shirt, she likes my old boots, she likes to slow dance, but to some old school. She'll take a full moon over them city nights, but I ain't scared to get all up in these bright lights. Yeah, I can smooth it out, I can stick it up, I guess that's why she can't get enough of a small town boy. Turn it up the team, girl. She can have I'm a ride-or-die, baby, I'm a cool, I'm a crazy, I'm a lay back in the front seat. I'm so with you till the end, girl, let's turn it up to 10, girl. She can have anybody that she wants to be, anywhere she wants to be. She loves a small town more like me. She's my ride-or-die, baby, she's my cool, she's my crazy, she's my lay back in the front seat. She's my with me till the end. A small town boy like me. She loves a small town boy like me. Hey. Yeah, she loves a small town boy like me. A small town boy like me.
Y'all changed our lives with this one. Thank you so much. I always like to dedicate this song to my grandma and granddad and all my family listening all over the place right now. That's the coolest part about playing the Opry. All my family and friends get to join in no matter where in the world they are. I wrote this song about my grandma and granddad's love story. And this one's called Cowboys and Angels. It goes like this right here. 2, 3, 4.
There's one, there's a name. There's a history between girls like her and guys like me. Cowboys and angels. Got boots, she's got wings. I'm hell on wheels and she's heavenly. I'd die for her if she lives for me. Cowboys and angels. And we ride side by side. Cloud of dust, rain line. My touch is her temptation. Her kiss is my salvation. She's sweet, I'm wild, we're dangerous. Cowboys and angels. An accident, a grand design. Oh, maybe God just kind of likes.
Amen.
Cowboys and angels. As we ride side by side, a cloud of dust. There's a want, there's a need. There's a history between
girls like you and guys like me. And cowboys and angels, cowboys and
my goodness, I sure do love that voice, and I sure do love that song. Dustin Lynch. Y'all, okay, well, to transition here, I also love, just about more than anything, chocolate. Now, more specifically, chocolate brownies. And even more specific than that, chocolate brownie batter. I'm one of those girls that loves to lick the bowl if I get the chance. We got anybody else like that? Well, Sonic has these new chocolate brownie batter shakes. So they take vanilla ice cream and brownie batter and they mix it all together, put whipped cream and a cherry on top, and it's unbelievable. And even if you aren't a chocolate brownie fan, that's okay. I may not understand it, but they got you covered with the yellow cake batter shake as well. So head to Sonic, try these amazing sweet treats. And you can get the Sonic app and order ahead of time now so you don't have to wait. Now, while we're on the subject of cake batter, we also have a long-standing tradition here at the Opry, especially on WSM 650 AM, with the birthday shout-outs and these live commercials. So we've partnered with Humana, and we want to say a big happy birthday to Dale Prax from Harriman, Tennessee. Happy birthday, Kaylee Adams from Roseville, California, turning 21. Keith and Phyllis Chessman from Baldwinville, Massachusetts, happy birthday. And we've got a happy anniversary to Ruth and Mark Tosinski from Watertown, Wisconsin. Happy birthday and happy anniversary. If you want to know more about Humana, you can visit humana.com. Now, okay, when you're planning all these parties, you got to find a one-stop shop where you can get everything you need. And you know where you can do that? You can do that at the Dollar General. Dollar General is amazing because they got the lowest prices, the name brands, and you don't have to run all around town to find your things, so you save time and money. And right now, we're going to keep the party going with a Dollar General gift card for an audience member. So if you're sitting in section 2, row P as in party, seat 14, where are we at? Section 2, row P, seat 14. Find your usher and get yourself a gift card from Dollar General. Congratulations, did we find him? Section 2, row P, seat 14. I hope you get your gift card. All right, well, we got to get back to more shows, so I'm going to throw it once again to my good friend Dustin Lynch.
So look, ladies and gentlemen, I had to bring my good friend MacKenzie Porter out here for an official debut of this song in front of all these amazing cameras, operators, and everybody. But we need you guys to make us look awesome too, all right? So if you know this next song, and hold on a second, before we get there, how many Canadians are out here again with MacKenzie?
Did you bring the whole family with you? Yeah, they're all my family. I got a big family.
You do, right? I mean, top to bottom. Thank you guys
for
joining us here in Nashville on this wonderful night at the Opry. And I don't know what else to say other than thank you to you guys for changing MacKenzie and my life, and all of these band guys you see on the stage tonight. Lies with this next song we're gonna play you. I wrote this song about reconnecting with an old flame, okay? It's called Think About You, check it out.
Well, look who it is, last call I thought I'd give. How's your mama, how you been? Girl, it's been too long. Saw your sister at the Circle K, her baby number 2 is on the way. Hadn't seen her since her wedding day with you on my own. It's good to hear from you again. Girl, what a coincidence. I was just thinking about that. Yeah.
Awesome. Ah, so much fun. See, we don't get to do that all the time with MacKenzie. That's rare for us. She makes me feel better about that song, you know, because I can't sing that high usually. Unless somebody stomps on my toes or something. Speaking of stomping on toes, I got a song that, it's a breakup song. This is always fun on live television when you can't figure out where your guitar, I'm gonna plug that, there it goes, all right. So this is a breakup song that we've never played before in front of an Opry crowd. Can I play it for you right now? All right. But at the same time, it's kind of a fun breakup song. So check this one out, it's called Party Mode. Here we go, baby.
How it all wound up. She took off flying in a cloud of dust. I ain't saying that it don't hurt, but I got a 90-proof way to make it work. Drinking every single drink, 7 nights a week. All over this town, doing that thing I do. Well, I sure do miss her and what we had, but there ain't no future in looking back. So I keep on rolling and moving on. I hope she comes back, but if she don't, I'll be drinking every single drink, 7 nights a week. All over this town, doing that thing I do and running from the truth. Bartender, one more round. Party mode, party mode, party mode. It's how it goes, how it goes, how it goes. Neon lights, honky tonks to the close. Party mode, party mode, party drink, 7 nights a week. And every bar in this town, doing that thing I do and running from the truth and burning it down. And
Tonight's Opry performance is in association with Shriners Hospitals for Children.
Dustin Lynch getting us in full-on party mode right now. I love that one.
Thank you, Miss Natalie. How are you doing?
I'm wonderful. I'm getting to talk to you. Okay, so we were talking with Chris earlier. We had a great picture of him and Vince Gill the night that Vince invited him to become a member. And your person was Trace Adkins, right?
Trace Adkins.
What do you remember from that? Tell us about
that. I'll tell you about Trace Adkins. He was the first country artist I ever met, and he called me a little shrimp in front of my girlfriend in high school.
Oh! So he was definitely your choice to
talk about
you.
Full circle moment, right?
Seriously.
That's the dude that ends up walking out on stage and inviting me to be a member of the Grand Ole Opry. And I gave him, well, I didn't give him a hug. He gave me a hug. I jumped in his big old arms. And then after we got off stage, I told him that story because he didn't know that story. And you know what he said? He goes, sounds about right.
Did he make any sort of apology at all?
I don't think Trace has ever apologized in a minute. Do you? When you're that big, you don't have to.
You don't have to, ever. So who ended up inducting you?
Reba McEntire.
Well, that's a flex if I ever heard one.
Right there. And it was a surprise. I told my team I didn't want to know who was going to induct me. So whenever they introduced Reba McEntire, and here she comes, she's my first crush ever, y'all. She comes walking out. I lost it. It was awesome.
That is unbelievable. Man, thank you so much for hanging out with us and telling us those stories. Dustin Lynch.
Thank you.
I love you. He is the absolute best. I mean, that is the most ridiculous and wonderful story. All right. I want to make sure and remind you guys to stick around at the end of the night, even though it seems like it's the end of the show. We'll say some goodbyes and stuff, but y'all stick around. You don't want to miss the last little bit of Chris Young. But I also want to send a big old shout out to Christopher McNeely's WVU kids that are here visiting Nashville for the first time and the Opry. Shout out. We got that tweet in. And you guys, thank you so much for sending in all of the comments week after week. We have all of our live streamers that always do that. But now we got to get to another TV break. So y'all, start applauding once again. It's been another great night of live music from this legendary stage. Thanks to MacKenzie Porter, Chris Young, and Dustin Lynch. You guys help keep the heart of country beating strong. Now, to take us out the door in style, one last time, here is Chris Young. Good night, y'all.
It's the last place left to fall, begging for another chance, if there's any chance at all, that you might still be listening, loving and forgiving guys like me. I spent my whole life getting it all. Could use your help from now on. I want to be a good man, but do like I should, man. I want to be the kind of man the mirror likes to see. I want to be a strong man and admit that I was wrong, man. God, I'm asking you. What you could do to put some love back in her heart, 'cause it's gonna take a miracle after all I've done to really make her see that I wanna be a stay man, I wanna be a great man, I wanna be the kind of man that she.
she sees in her dreams. God, I want to be your man, and I want to be her man. God, I only hope she still leaves, and the man I want to be. Well, I know this lady, not the tall she.
Thank you very much for that one right there. That was that was one with a lot more than two chords. And the reason that I say that is because this next song is literally that's the whole song. The whole thing. This is the least number of chords I've ever used in a song that I wrote in my entire life. Here we go. It's called Raised on Country.
Thank you.
There we go. It's never fun when you unplug that when it's still on. It's not fun for you guys. It's not fun for me. Something will come from the soundboard over that way thrown at my head. Hang on, wait, come back. They're applauding for you at the Opry. I could do a big long intro for this one, but I'm pretty sure I'm already way past the time I was supposed to be at anyway, so we're just gonna play it. It's called Famous Friends. My buddy Brandon owns a record for single season touchdown throws. Good old Johnny, he's alive of every party. It's like Cheers, you know him everywhere he goes. I've got some famous friends you probably never heard of. Back in Rutherford County, our ground is second to none. You might not know me in this big city we're in. When I go back home, I got some famous friends. Yeah, I do. Buddy Jason, he's a sheriff. He'll flash his lights, but let me go. My boy Randy's a preacher. My girl Megan, she's been teacher of the year. Served for 5 years in a row. I've got some famous friends you probably never heard of. Back in Hamilton County, our crowd is sick. About the people that you know. Got some famous friends you probably never heard.